Hey folks, it's Frithgar here. How you doing? I have got a trailer load of wood here. I'm just going to get the last couple of logs that fell off and I'll chuck these in by hand. We're going to throw in a few more logs into the placeable here, but what we're going to do is we're going to remove this ramp. And I have had someone suggest to me, it was Grantham actually, I think, the person who provided me with the map that we could use to do our comparisons with. He actually said that it might be that the placeable isn't able to get closer to the machine here because of the wood chips. Now, I can't remember. I think we did actually have the wood chips there before we tried putting the placeable down. So what we're going to do is we're going to sell the placeable. So if I just do that a moment, we want to go to garage and owned items. We want to zip up through here. There we go. So it's that ramp there. Yes, I want to sell it. Okay, so that one's gone. And I want to get another ramp, but before I do that, I'm going to get something different to help remove the wood chips. Now, we could just use a front loader. We could get the Manitou up here and use the front loader and just sort of scoop them up and move them out of the way. But I figured that that wouldn't be, you know, quite so much fun. I figured that there was another way that we could do this. You can see I've got a nice trailer load of wood here, so we can do the whole log thing again. A couple of people have said to me in the comment section that using this one to sell our timber gets a much higher quantity of, you get a lot more money for it than you do if you transport logs at 8 meter lengths up to the sawmill. It's just a bit more work involved. So what I want to do is I want to try and figure out the optimum way of getting wood into this thing so that we could do it nearly as quickly as we could do a load of logs onto the floor, load them up onto the timber runner and run them up there, because of the huge amount of extra money that we could get from it. But first of all, for our little task that we're going to do here, we need to get up to the dealership so that we can pick up a new machine that we're going to get up there and a conveyor belt to go with it. And we're going to pick up all of these wood chips, and I'm not quite sure what we're going to do with them yet. Okay, we're just coming to the dealership here, and we'll get our new... It's a new tractor, actually. And it's a modded one. It's in the beta section, so it's not available on console, but it is available on PC. Where is it? There we go. It's this one here. Now, I've not looked up to see if this is based on anything in real life. It could be based on something in real life if it was a custom made job, if it's not something that is generally available. Now, do we go for, we won't use wide tires, we use standard. You can have the number plates invisible or visible, so we'll leave the number plate on, and then you've got platform off, which is like that there. You have the tipper function. Or you've got platform on, which is just a flat platform that you could stack some logs or bales or something like that on, and you can put straps onto it. I don't want to do that. I want to have the platform off, and I'm going to lease this one because I don't think we'll keep it. Although I'm not certain yet, so I'm going to lease it for today, and possibly, you know, we'll be using it again tomorrow just to see what it's like. My question that I asked you all last week, now let's just go into here. Do I want to change the color on this one? How much does it cost to change colors? $100. So it's 408 instead of 400, isn't it? You know what? I think we're going to go for that color there. Kind of a... Is that teal? I'm not sure. But yeah, we're going to use that color there. So it will blend in with the woodland that we're going to be working on. So anyway, my question I asked you last week was, do you want me to get Mahu and Kevin's sawmill? And generally, people said yes. I'll show you the sawmill. Where are we? Keep coming through. There it is. That one there, Sage Work, the lizard sawmill where you got to put in logs and you got to put in fuel and you get out timber and you get wood chips come out as well. So 2,622 people answered that question. 165 thought that I shouldn't get the sawmill and 2,457 of you thought that I should get the sawmill. I think it's fairly overwhelmingly positive for getting the sawmill. So let's just take a quick look at this one. We will get the sawmill. We're not going to use it today, but we are going to get it. So this is our little Fendt with the tipper on the front. It's an old cab that layout. So I really don't know if this is a real thing or not. I really hope that it is. It would be really cool. You've got a general tipper function on it. So if I use the tip anywhere, you can just tip anywhere. The only thing I've noticed is that you've got the platform that can go on the front. If you load this thing up with bales, you're going to struggle to see where you're going unless you go backwards. I don't think you could go backwards on it. So anyway, that's the tipper function on it. Let me just come out of cab. So yeah, I really don't know, but if you have a look, let me just tip it up again. You have a look at the way the frame is built. I would say that even if this is not a real thing, it's something that someone somewhere will have made. Not necessarily with this tractor, but they will have made it somewhere. Some of the colours are a little flat on here by the look of it, but generally I think this is a very good mod. I really like it. If you have a look up here, I would say most likely, if you were to have something like this, that seems like a bit of a weak point there to me. If you were to use this thing for any length of time, I suspect that would become quite weakened there. I would think that that there, I would say that you'd want to extend the frame sort of out here and back along and join in with the cab and make it more robust. It just sort of feels like it's not all that robust, like the, you know, just the way that it is. So I'll just turn that off, and I want to go there, and I want to go there. You've got to be careful when you have the conveyor belts that you don't accidentally set them to tip anywhere, because then when you start using them, they tip anywhere. And by anywhere, I just mean right behind you, which is a bit of a nuisance. So we won't worry about that. But look, it does, it drives along quite nicely. I do like it. I like the look of this thing. I've seen various machines that have been manufactured by farmers that are pretty handy with a welder, fairly mechanically minded, and they will build things like this just in their workshop for their own use. It's not something that is kind of a general sale item, and you know, it's not something that a lot of farmers would want to use. I mean, what are you going to use that for? You'd be better off just to have a tractor with a link box on the back or something like that. But on the other hand, it's very cool looking. It is very, very cool. I really like it. So my question for this week is all about this one. We're going to use this one today and possibly a couple more times this week. It's quite simply, do you want me to buy this tractor? It's $45,000, so it's not ridiculously expensive. It's not going to have a lot of uses. There's not a huge amount of things that we can do with it, but we could, for example, we could take it to the workshop, put the platform on instead of the tipper function, and nip back down to the cattle, get a few bales of hay down there, throw them on, stack them up a bit, put the straps on and drive it up to the sheep. It'd be the perfect way to feed the sheep, that sort of thing. So yes or no, do you want me to add this to our fleet of tractors? If you do, we will have to buy it. If you don't, then we will lease it this week and possibly next week, and then we will return it and we won't use it anymore. So it's your vote, it's your game. Head into the comment section down below, let us know what you want and why. And of course, don't forget to actually cast your vote in the top right-hand corner by mousing over and clicking on the little white circle, or tapping it with your finger. So yeah, I know that everybody can vote, even if you're on the mobile. I did think that you couldn't vote if you were on mobile, but apparently that's not true, you can. So yeah, if you're on, it doesn't matter what platform you're watching me on, you can cast your vote as well. I'll get this one over to the forest, and what I'm going to do is I'll show you rather than just telling you. Right, while we drive through the forest, we can have a good look at this tractor and see what it's got in the way of suspension. It doesn't look like it's got any kind of suspension. I really like the fact that the back wheels are not jumping up and down. Because normally you would have, on older tractors, newer tractors, you do get some rear suspension. Not all of them, but some of them you do. This would be a solid axle. You wouldn't expect the wheels to be moving up and down, and they're not, which is absolutely fantastic. But also the front wheels on this one, there is no suspension on those wheels. They're not moving from side to side, they're not moving up and down. You have got a very rigid body tractor, which I would guess that if you were actually using this tractor, it would make for a very uncomfortable ride. I think it does move a little. Yeah, it is moving a little bit, but generally the suspension on this is extremely poor when compared to a regular tractor, and the way the suspension works on the front wheels on a regular tractor. So yeah, we've got that, and to my mind, that makes this thing more realistic. Not less so, but more so. Because you've got the, it's something that has been knocked together in a shed, in a farmer's shed. He's just sort of put it together himself and done the best that he can do with it. So yeah, I'm loving this. I'm absolutely loving this mod. So if I just lift that one up, when we move forward now, I need to turn it on. It's most likely going to pick up those wood. There we go. It's already picked up the wood chips. And if you put the tip anywhere going, when you do something like this, it will immediately start pouring them over the back. So what I want to do is I'm going to put that one right there, because it'll pick up quite a way in front of you and to the sides, but it won't pick up behind you, which is always a bit of a nuisance. So now, I can't raise that one up any higher. This is our only problem. I can't raise it any higher than it is, and I don't think the tractor is going to fit underneath. Not quite. Is there any way to tip side front unload here? Stop engine. No, right. So, oh, hang on. There's a mouse button there. What's that for? Move it. What am I moving? I'm moving something. Oh! Oh, that's brilliant! Of course, yes, on these types of hitches, you can move them, can't you? You can put them down to put the trailer on, or you've got to move them up so that you've got room to put the PTO on. I mean, I've never used that type of hitch, so I don't really know, but that's the only thing that we've got that's movable on this tractor. So I don't think we're going to be able to quite load it up. It doesn't fit. So that means we're going to have to go and get another conveyor belt, or we're going to have to figure out another way of doing this. I really wanted to just be able to tip it in with this conveyor belt. It would be very, very simple if we could just use this conveyor belt. It's just not lifting. It's not quite high enough, is it? Can I kind of wedge the conveyor belt underneath? Is that possible? No, it doesn't look like it. That's a bit of a shame, that is. We're going to have to go and get one of the other conveyor belts. I think I'll use the Valtra to do that, because it's a bit faster than this one. We'll run back over to the farm and we'll get one of the ones that we got on our little setup for our seed and our... I want that one on. I want the rear trailer off. We'll get one of the ones that we're using on our fertilizer and seed setup. So yeah, I'll run back and get that. I'll empty the conveyor belt back out into the shed. We'll bring it over here. It's a bit of a nuisance having to do that. I was hoping to be able to do this with just the one conveyor belt, but it's... Let me have a play around. I'll get back to you in a minute. We'll either have the conveyor belt over here, or I'll have figured something out with this one. Okay, I brought this one up. So we can technically just scoop up the bucketfuls of wood chips, because I figured this would actually be easier than trying to mess around with the bigger conveyor belt. Just thought it would generally be a lot easier. So what we can do is we can pick it up like this and we can tip it straight in. We've got a huge great big bucket here, plenty of room in it. Before I do any more, I nearly forgot. I featured a adaptation of the UAL bale trailer a little while ago. Rich 27, was it? Helped me make it. And what he did was, not that one, this one. I think it was this one. I can't remember which one it is now. We've got two of one. We got two of the one. Yeah, we got two of that one. So that's the one that he helped me do. This one here, the Flegal Transport Runner UAL, I will probably sell the two of those that we've got or return them, and then we can uninstall that one so that we've just got this one now. The original mod creator, TSM Modding, in conjunction with ARM, the people that made the small baler, they have now made the... they've updated this one. It's just come out today, Monday morning, and this one now takes the small bale, the ARM small bale from that Welga baler, you know, the one that we were using. It's that one right there. The ARM team that made this Welga baler here, they've also... There we go. If you go to www.arm-team.gr, they've got that small baler. They've got an extreme baling pack, which is actually Heston bales. The new UAL trailer, that one, Universal Auto Load trailer, that one will also load those big bales. It loads the standard big bales in the game, which are these sizes, quadrant size. I've always called them quadrant size, and then you've got Heston size bales, which are nearly double the size of those bales. And the trailer will load those as well. That's, like I said, the baler for that is from the ARM team. You've got to get it on their website. It's not on ModHub. It loads, there's some big pallets from another modding group. I'm not sure what the pallets are yet. I've not really looked into that. It loads 1.3 meter standard round bales plus 1.4 meter round bales. So I wasn't aware that there was a 1.4 meter baler out there. So I'm assuming there must be if they've gone to the trouble of adding that script in there. So where that bale is, I'm not quite sure, but it's there somewhere. And I'll see if I can find out on that one, actually, the 1.4 meter. And then plus all the other ones that it had on there anyway, you know, the pallets and various different types of round bales and so on and so forth. So, yeah, you've got a very universal auto-loading trailer. It's absolutely fantastic. I encourage you, if you're on PC, to download it and use it. Unfortunately, it's not available on console because of all the scripts. So let's just tip this in here. I am curious exactly how much we can fit into this tractor because... right. What have I just done? Have I... No! Oh, no, no, no! You can't do that! Come on, Frith! Oh, I've got thousands and thousands of hours driving load alls. I cannot go smashing someone's cab now. I've never done it in real life. This is not the time to start. Right, so I've put a full bucket full in there, and it does sort of look, if you look at the volume, it does look a bit like that bucket should be about the same as that tipper on there. However, it does look like it's allowing us to have a little more. Now, the theory is I should be able to put this one under here and load it up. Apparently, that theory is incorrect. That theory does not work. So let's jump onto here and try tip anywhere. What does that do? Tip anywhere puts it through the bucket and onto the floor. Why does this not work? Frithgar does not approve. This has not received Frithgar's stamp of approval. Maybe if we just pick that bit up there. It's quite difficult to pick it up. I was hoping to do this with a conveyor belt. I wanted the conveyor belt just because it's, you know, cool using the conveyor belts. And I really like them. I know that they're a bit of a nuisance. And in FS15, we had the one from Mahu that was... You just, you know, stuck it on the front of the tractor or on the front loader and plonked it down on the ground. And it just sort of did its stuff, did its thing. And it was absolutely cool. There was no complaints with that one whatsoever. It just did everything you wanted it to do. Whereas this, not so much. I thought that it would tip into a bucket. That is bitterly disappointing to me. Right, so we can't tip it into a bucket. But so we're going to have to just use the conveyor belt, stick it in a heap. If I put the universal tip anywhere... going on that, it'll gather up the stuff that's round the rest of it and then tip it in a heap here in front of me. There's a little bit left over there. Right, it's picked up all of that and it's tipped it in a heap. So I've at least made the heap a little tidy. It's not really what the kind of the experience that I was after. I wanted to be able to just use the conveyor belt. Well, some things work out well for us and others don't seem to work out quite so good. So let me just stop that one there. We'll get back into the Manitou and I'll get that pile of wood chips out the way. If we pick that up and move it, you know, spin round. And if I pick this lot up here, it's quite difficult sometimes to actually get everything up off of the floor. Especially if it's uneven ground. Because of the way that the bucket doesn't quite dig into the ground and it easily lifts the machine up into the air. But we can do it. So if we come on round here. Now, I've got to remember not to smash into that cab. If I was in here, actually, I wouldn't be able to see very well. I would probably... I mean, you can load from this angle. I mean, I would actually just move my head slightly and lean forward so that I could see what I was doing a little better. But generally speaking... I would try to load it so I was on the other side of the tractor so that I could easily see the front of that tractor and where the cab was, and then I wouldn't damage anything with the bucket on this loader. I'm guessing that a lot of other people do as well. I mean, yes, it's not a problem with loading it on the offside, so that you can't quite see it properly, but I generally would always try to load it the other way round if at all possible. I mean, even when I was loading bales onto lorries with loadalls, what I would do is load them all from one side. The bales would go onto two sides of the lorry, but I would actually always try to load them all from one side. I just found it a lot easier, and I found that I could do a bit of a better job if I did it like that. And not all loadall drivers would do that. Some of them would load it from both sides. I mean, occasionally I would load them from both sides. It sort of depended what I was doing and, what I was able to do on the day. So how much have we got in here? We've got 8,500 litres. We will find somewhere to tip that. Probably not today, actually, because we are going to be running out of time soon. Oh, I know what we need to do. Before we do anything else, we want to get another ramp in here. We want to get the other ramp that I've got. So, yeah, the UAL trailer, it's now out. Anybody that wanted to be able to use the auto-load small bale trailer is now on Mod Hub. It's the first one available there on the beta section. Knock yourselves out with it. It's absolutely fantastic. We may even just bring it back into the game just to see what differences there are. Sell two that we got and buy two replacements just so that we can see them in action. I'm not quite sure when I'm going to do that, though. Now then, let me just move forward. The problem I've got at the moment, you can see I'm moving ever so slightly. The reason I'm moving ever so slightly is my joystick is moving me ever so slightly, which is not particularly convenient. So let's just bring that one round. So this is a bigger ramp. It's a much bigger ramp than we were using last time. I tried to use it in the... Ooh, I tell you what, it'll fit there quite nicely, but it's just a question of... I think if we come round the other side, we'll be able to see it a little bit better to load it up, position it and everything. And we come down here. Right, this is where it gets a bit tricky. We've got to find a way to load it. We can go... Actually, we can place this right through that placeable there. The only issue is that tree up the top. So where am I going to put it? That tree is going to be in the way. I don't want it sort of too unrealistic. That's a long way up in the air, isn't it? I know that is one issue I found with this thing, is it does sort of plonk the ramps a long way up in the air if you're trying to do them on a slope. If we do this, we could end up with a floating ramp. I don't really want a floating ramp. It would be better if the ramp was in the ground. And also, if I bring it up there, I got a feeling that the front of that ramp is going to be like a bit of a lip on it, and it's not going to be... Maybe if I can bring it over there and rotate it round ever so slightly, I'm going to have to clip into the side of that machine, but I think that would be okay, actually. I don't want to clip it too much. Bring it up like that, maybe. Let's try that. If we don't like this, we can always come back. Okay, I really, really don't like the way it's floating. And we've got an awfully big lip here. But the problem is, you can't pick up a placeable and move it, can you? I don't think you can. I think once you've got it there, you're stuck with it. We could cut down that tree so that we could move the ramp round. No, what I was thinking is to move the actual chipper thing there. Let's go back to placeables. We go garage and we'll sell that one. Yes. Back here and go back to the shop. So let's try this again. I'm actually going to do this now. I'm going to try and find the optimal way. Oh, actually, no, because if we do it this way, it's going to, again, it's going to be sticking up out of the ground. I don't think you can really place it there very easily. And it's sticking out of the ground. We're not going to be able to get onto the ramp there, right? I'll figure something out here. I'll see if I can find a way to place it. And I'll also see if there is a way to move... I don't think you can move placeables, can you? Once the placeables are there, you're stuck with it. I'll sort this out, and then I'll get back to you. Short of moving the actual Jenz HE700 there out and putting it down somewhere much more level, and then putting the ramp beside it, I don't think we've got much choice. We're going to end up with this floating ramp like this, which is a real shame. I was hoping that you could, like, push them down a little bit. I was trying all sorts of different angles, and I've just not been able to get it to work. So, unfortunately, we're sort of stuck with it like this. I am wondering if maybe we should just sell the HE700 move it and then try again. But I mean, we're not going to be using it that much more, so I think that we could leave it here, and then maybe we'll just bring back the other ramp. And rather than trying to use a big trailer like this, we could use a smaller trailer. I can get the trailer up onto the ramp. I am falling off the side of the ramp, and I have run out of time. So we're going to get this one trailer full tipped in here, and maybe we'll try using that Fendt, although the Fendt will need this higher ramp. It would help if I could back in a straight line. I should clear some of these trees around here. It's not easy to see what I'm doing with all these trees like they are. It also doesn't help that the wheels are turning like this on the back of this trailer. So let's back up here. And I'm hoping the whole idea of this was to have the trailer at less of a slope when we start tipping. So there we go. That's a long way up in the air. But if this works, this is going to be really cool. So let's just see. Is it going to work? Are we going to be able to tip the logs? Right, it is working. We've put one log in so far. What are the rest going to do? There's another one. They're thinking about sliding out. To be honest, it's not a huge amount different to what it was last time. Only now we're way up in the air compared to the other one. So we might, I think we're just going to have to give up on this. And we'll get the smaller one, get that one back. That might be the best option. Because looking at this, it's not liking it, is it? Oh, yes! Look at the piles of logs coming out. Okay, it is working a little bit. It's working a bit better than... Okay, I'm throwing them everywhere. Okay, this probably isn't the best way to do it. But there's no denying that this is a lot of fun. Right, let's get a few of these up here and try chucking them on. Can I push them? Let me push forward a bit. And ram it. There we go. Right. So if you're in trouble with a machine like this, the best way to do it is to climb into the infeed of the machine while it's running, jump up and down on it. There's no health and safety issues with that whatsoever, obviously, is there? Because, let's just ignore that. And if you are using something like this at home, do not climb into the infeed of the machine. It's not necessarily the best idea you'll ever have. It's probably also the last idea you'll ever have. Right. Just grab these and chuck these in really quickly. There we go. We are getting a nice bit of money from it. So it might be worth trying to sell this one and then move the placeable and put it somewhere that is dead level. Ooh, I got one more idea. I don't know how well it's going to work. What I'm going to have to do is I'm going to try it out on a test map just to see how it works. And then I've got to find somewhere that's dead level that I can actually do it on. If it works, I can show you. Maybe tomorrow. Although we do want to actually get that sawmill installed. I'm not quite sure we're going to put that one yet. Maybe we'll put the sawmill back at our main yard. I have seen some pictures of people using the sawmills actually in their main yard. See, all the logs are coming off the end. I'm trying to shake them out. There we go. There's a few of them out. Come back a bit. And the last few. Go on, you can do it. I love this. I don't think I would get bored with tipping the logs out like that anytime soon. Let me just come round here. I'll run round the front of the tractor. See, another 5,200 in wood. You get a fortune selling them like this, don't you? It really does seem to be worth doing. Chuck those down there. I'll tell you what, if we were to tip them all on the ramp, we could maybe then just push them in with a bucket. Another way of doing it. Perhaps that is another way of doing it. If we could stick all of these down somewhere, then we could just use the Manitou and shove them in. Ooh, I've got loads of ideas of how we could do this, but it's not going to involve having a placeable up here. What we would do is we would cut the logs into 1 meter lengths using that one into a trailer. We'd have to transport them elsewhere and then do it. Either that or just have cut a few trees a bit closer to wherever we set the thing up. Not quite sure yet, so I'll probably, I think we'll have a look at the sawmill tomorrow, just so that we can try something a little bit different. We also need to do something with these wood chips. My question for this week is, this tractor right here, the Fendt with the tipper on the front, it's actually called, if I go into the garage and look at our leased items, there we go, whiz through, there we go, it's the Fendt GT 255. Do you want me to buy this tractor as a permanent addition to our fleet? Do you think this would be a useful machine to have, or do you think I should just leave it and, you know, return it to the shop after we've used it for a little while and tried it out? It's your vote, it's your game. Head into the comment section down below, let us know what you'd like. And of course, don't forget to actually cast your vote in the top right-hand corner. I'm going to just move this one out of the way. We probably won't be using this one tomorrow. I think we're going to try the sawmill tomorrow. Like I said, we're doing at least a couple of weeks of forestry stuff. So we've sort of had a look at the ramp and we've had a look at the wood chips loading up into that one. I've got an idea for this, but I don't know if it's going to work here. We will probably need to move it for my idea, although we could possibly do it here. We will have to see. That's something that's on the cards possibly for the end of this week, maybe even the beginning of next week. We shall see. If you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.